Yung Philippine Coast Guard natin, mga kababayan, naglagay na ng tinatawag na sovereign marker sa kalayaan na group of islands. So, ito yung patunay na seryoso yung ating Pangulong Bongbong Marcos sa kanya pong promise that not an square inch of our territory will be abandoned and given up to any foreign power. Yeah, di ba yun yung promise niya? Ito ngayon, mga kababayan, ang ginawa ng Philippine Coast Guard. Di ba? Never ito na nangyari, mga kababayan, during the time of Mauding. Kahit yung mga previous administrations pa, yung mga dilawan po, si Panot, and the rest of the, leaders, naging leader ng ating bansa, hindi po ginawa yung ganyan. So, patunay po na BBM lang yung sakalam.
BBM!
But before ko ibigay sa inyo, mga kababayan, yung kwentong yan, click subscribe mo na dito sa ating YouTube channel para lagi kayong updated sa mga kaganapan dito sa ating bayan. And i-hit din ninyo po yung ating notification bell. At huwag na rin po ninyo, mga kababayan, na i-skip yung ating mga commercial ads para pandagdag lang po sa pambili ng mga markers. Buya, mga ang tawag po, sovereign boys or navigational boys. Ah, ito po siya. At may flag, may bandila ng ating Pilipinas. Minarkada po ng Philippine Coast Guard. So, mabuhay ang Pilipinas. Mabuhay ang ating Pangulo. Nilagyan, mga kababayan, ng marker ang ating karagatan sa Kalayaan Group of Islands. Ayan po. Ita niya. Pwede palang gawin, mga kababayan. Importante lang, yung leader natin, kailangang may political will at saka matapang. Pero yung tapang, mga kababayan, hindi yon dinadala sa mga, dinadala sa angas. Di ba? Hindi dinadaan, sa angas. Kundi ginagawa talaga niya po. So sabi rito, Philippine Coast Guard, West Philippine Sea. Philippine Coast Guard naglagay ng karagdagang buya sa West Philippine Sea. Naging matagumpay ang Philippine Coast Guard sa paglalagay ng karagdagang navigational buoys or buya sa Kalayaan Group of Islands na sakop ng West Philippine Sea. Ito yung ginawa, mga kababayan, ng Coast Guard natin matapos na ipag-utos ng ating Pangulong Bongbong Marcos. Na kailangan niya, una, mag-mapping po tayo, sabi ng ating Pangulo. Mag-mapping niya tayo. Ipipresent natin yan sa ating Chinese counterpart na ito yung mga areas na ito territory namin. At lagyan natin ng marker. At dito, bawal dito ang sino mang foreign power na papasok. Di ba? Without, authority from us. Ito din niya yung magiging lugar kung saan ma-identify ng sino man, lalo na ng siyempre ng ating mga mamamayang Filipino, yung ating mga mangingisda, kung saan sila pwede na mangisda peacefully kasi alam nila na ito ay well within our territory. Yun, mga kababayan, yung gustong mangyari ng ating Pangulong Bongbong Marcos para maiwasan po yung gulo. Pasok ng pasok yung China claiming na kanila na lahat. What? Di ba? Wala kasing marker. At talagang intensyon yon mga kababayan ng China, kasi yung lahat ng areas doon, kanila daw, kiniklaim nilang kanila. So kabilang dito ang Patak Island, Balagtas Reef, Kota Island, Panata Island, at Julian Felipe Reef. So sabi rito, ayon kay PCG, Maritime Safety Services Commander, Vice Admiral Joseph Coime, nagsisilbi itong gabay ng mga Pilipinong mangingisda at malalaking barko na naglalayag sa WPS or West Philippine Sea. Anya, maituturing din itong sovereign markers sa kalayaan group of island na bahagi ng exclusive economic zone ng ating bansa. Di ba? Napakaganda ng initiative na ginagawa ng ating gobyerno. Sa utos mga kababayan ng ating Pangulong Bongbong Marcos, yung ating Pangulong Bongbong, mga kababayan, organized siya na mag-isip, detalyado. Yun ang kagandahan sa ating Pangulo. So sabi ng Philippine Coast Guard, itong sovereign markers at critical areas show resolve to protect waters. So sabi rito mga kababayan, ito yung Coast Guard Chief. 5 navigational buoys or sovereign markers have been successfully installed in critical areas of the West Philippine Sea. Sabi ng Philippine Coast Guard, the buoys installed near Patak Island, Balagtas Reef, Kota Island, Panata Island, and one Philippi Reef carry the Philippine flag and signify the country's sovereign rights and jurisdiction over the country's exclusive economic zone, sabi po ng Philippine Coast Guard. Ito'y para malinaw sa mga Chinese na madalas mga kababayan pumapasok sa ating territory tapos pinapalayas tayo. What? Umalis na niya kayo dyan. Imagine, territory natin, bansa natin, pinapalayas tayo ng China. Ganon ang ginagawa nila mga kababayan. O ngayon, at tapos sasabihin nila sa kanila, o para malinaw, lagyan natin ng marker. Linagyan mga kababayan ng Philippine Coast Guard para alam nila na hindi kanila mismo, ating territory ang pinapasok nila at kiniklaim sa kanila. So sabi rito, the move also highlights the country's unwavering resolve to protect its maritime borders and resources and contribute to the safety of maritime trade, sabi po ng Philippine Coast Guard. The PCG's Task Force Kaligtasan sa Karagatan, led by Vice Admiral Joseph Coime, led the placing of the buoys, itong mga buya. Now, sabi rito, meanwhile, the Philippine Coast Guard said that they are currently monitoring several alleged Chinese militia ships anchored inside the country's territory. Doon mismo nakatingga mga kababayan, sa loob na mismo ng ating territory. In an interview, Coime said that there is no heightened tension between the country's law enforcement agencies and the Chinese vessels in the area. Our approach is diplomatic, anya. We are not yet in a situation where tensions are heightened. With our ships there, we are normally conducting our law enforcement functions pertaining to maritime safety, and this is not provocative in nature. Paliwanag po niya. O ngayon, sabi rito mga kababayan, as more navigational buoys are needed to mark the country's maritime borders, the Philippine Coast Guard may turn to the Philippine Navy for help in installing more of them in the West Philippine Sea. Sabi po ng isang congressman, na-inspire yung si Congressman Rufus Rodriguez nang makita niya na maganda yung ginagawa ng Philippine Coast Guard. Patulong na anya kayo sa Philippine Navy. Ayas? Sabi po ni Rofos, the Coast Guard should install more buoys in the entire breadth of the WPS from the northern part of the country in the Ilocos region to the south in Palawan area because that is the extent of Philippine territorial waters. China is claiming. Paliwanag mga kababayan ng congressman. The chairman of the House Committee on Constitutional Amendments na si Rufus Rodriguez. Ganon din mga kababayan yung sinabi ni National Security Advisor Eduardo Anyo. Sabi niya, the country needs more navigational buoys aside from the 10 installed by the Philippine Coast Guard. I earnestly hope that the Philippine Coast Guard continues to deploy buoys in other maritime features in the West Philippine Sea throughout the remainder of your term. Anyo said, addressing Coast Guard Commandant Admiral Artemio Abo. Ngayon, sabi naman po ni Congressman Rodriguez, the marker should serve as a warning to the Chinese and other foreign intruders that those are a demarcation of our 200-mile exclusive economic zone under international law. Sabi ng congressman, China should leave the area. They have no business occupying certain islets and sea features there. As he commended the Philippine Coast Guard leadership for placing 5 new navigational buoys in the areas in the West Philippine Sea na kiniklaim din mga kababayan ng mga Chinese. The Mindanao lawmaker said the Philippine Coast Guard should procure more buoys in that funding for the acquisition of the marker should be included in its budget proposal to the Department of Budget and Management and Congress. Rodriguez said, the Philippine Coast Guard should also place buoys near Bajo de Masinloc, also called Panatag or Scarborough Shoal. Ito na yung kinamkam, mga kababayan. Pinabayaan ito nung panahon ni Panot. Ito yung kinamkam na po ng mga Chinese. This is which is about 120 miles from Zambales. Yun ang distance lang niya mga kababayan. In Pangasinan, and a traditional fishing ground of Filipino fishermen from two provinces sa matagal ng panahon. Ngayon, laging pinalalayas doon yung ating mga mangingisda. That is anya clearly part of the of our exclusive economic zone. And yet, China is occupying it. Yung panahon nga po ni Panot. The Chinese Coast Guard routinely harass our fishermen there. China seized Panatag Shoal in 2012 after a standoff between the Chinese Coast Guard and the Philippine Navy. May na kasi mga kababayan yung leader natin at lahing Chinese. Si Panot, abnormal pa kung mag-isip. So sabi po ni Anyo, let us show that we are promoting and supporting safe, peaceful, and free navigation, Anya. But more than that, we are serious and determined in protecting and defending our right, territory, and sovereignty. Aside from serving as sovereign markers, the buoys are also floating aids to navigation that direct fishermen and passing vessels to safe passage. Madali niya nilang makita mga kababayan. So magsisilbi itong navigational guide sa kanila. So President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has made it clear that he will not allow any foreign power to take even an inch of our territory. So ito yung patunay na yung promise ng ating Pangulong Bongbong Marcos during the campaign, mga kababayan, na hindi niya hahayaan na sino mang foreign power come in, not even an inch of our territory. Hindi na. I'll not preside over any process that will abandon even a square inch of our territory of the Republic of the Philippines to any foreign power. Yan po yung exact statement ng ating Pangulong Bongbong Marcos. Hindi ko ayaanan yan na any foreign power ay kamkamin yung ating territory. Yan ang patunay ng isang strong leader, mga kababayan, na sabi ni Mau Diggs, weak. Baliktad po, mga kababayan. So, sabi ni Anyo, I am certain, Anya, that the commandant of the PCG along with 26,400 Coast Guardians have answered his call with patriotic fervor, sabi po ni Anyo, referring to the call of the President na paigtingin yung pagbabantay, mga kababayan, dito sa ating territorial waters. This act of marking the boundaries with our national flag signals our unwavering resolve to safeguard our aquatic borders and resources. Furthermore, it underscores our adherence to global statutes, specifically the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea, which acknowledges coastal states' entitlement to manage the exclusive economic zone, sabi po ni Anyo. He praised the Coast Guard for vigorously performing its task, not based on brute force, but rather buttressed by international and domestic laws. So, sumusunod tayo sa international law. Hindi tayo bully tulad ng sinasabi mga kababayan ng mga Chinese. Yung gawain nila, mga kababayan na pambubuli, binibigay nila sa atin, binabaliktaran tayo. Binabaliktad po tayo kasi daw dumikit tayo sa Amerika, naging bully na tayo. Ganon ang kanilang mga reasoning, mga kababayan. Ito mga barkada ni Mau Diggs. Ayun man lang po. Baka lang gusto ninyo itong itry, Firmax Firming and Lifting Cream, pinapahid sa mga pulses and affected area. Mainam po sa paninigas ng mga kaso-kasoan. Ito naman po, Automax Radiant Serum. Sa mukha naman yung application. Anti-aging po siya. You will look 10 years younger than your age. Sa mga cancer patients naman po, baka lang gusto ninyo itong itry, Nengsha Red Mixed Fruit Drink. Hindi man po siya gamot, food supplement siya. Kaya lang, gawa siya, mga kababayan, sa goji berry. Yung goji berry may anti-cancer properties. Ayos! Ako po si Dante Maravillas. Ay, yung mga inquiries ninyo, dumiritso na lang po pala kayo sa aming messenger sa Facebook para masagot namin agad. Ayos! Bye-bye po. God bless!